So let's move on to quaternion multiplication. Okay, so this is sometimes called the quaternion product. Or the Hamilton product. Okay, and it's a little bit different. So the rules are a little different than maybe what we're used to for products. So so let's take the two quaternions here. We'll do A and B again. So A, and because the rules are a little bit different, we're going to do an X with a circle around it. That's going to represent our quaternion product, and multiply that with B. Okay, so the rules are actually just distributive. So so let's write this out in the longhand here. So it's A0 plus AX in the I-hat direction plus AY in the J-hat direction plus AZ in the K-hat direction. And we're going to multiply that by B0 plus BX in the I-hat direction plus BY in the J-hat direction plus BZ in the K-hat direction. Okay, so so again, this is just distributive, so we can just multiply things through. So let's start off with A-naught and multiply A-naught through each of these terms here. So we're going to have this is equal to A-naught times B-naught plus A-naught times BX in the I-hat direction plus A-naught times BY in the J-hat direction plus A-naught times BZ in the K-hat direction. Okay, and then we could keep going. I'm just going to do one more row here. So the next one would be AX in the I-hat direction. So we've got this next term here, and then we're going to multiply it through each of these. So AX in the I-hat direction times B naught plus AX in the I-hat direction times BX in the I-hat direction plus AX I-hat times BY J-hat plus AX I-hat times BZ K-hat. Okay, and then we could continue down. So we'd have the next thing would be AY times J-hat multiplied by everything in that B quaternion. And then finally AZ K-hat times everything in the B quaternion. But I wrote out these first two so you can see a couple things here. So so first of all, this is distributive, and so we're going to get a bunch of different terms in here. So for example, we're going to end up with scalar terms, right? A naught times B naught, that's just a scalar term, and so that's going to end up in our quaternion. So when we multiply two quaternions together, we're going to get a quaternion out that has a scalar component and then some vector components. Now the vector components are a little tricky here because you can see in some places, well, for example, this first line here, we've got a scalar times a component in the I-hat, J-hat, and K-hat directions. So those are going to come out in our new quaternion, that they'll have components in the I, J, and K directions. But then we have some interesting things here. We have an I-hat times an I-hat. So what do we do with an I-hat times an I-hat, right? Or we have an I-hat times a J-hat, or an I-hat times a K-hat. Well, it turns out this is one of the enlightening things that Hamilton discovered. These are the rules here that go along with this. So if we have an I-hat multiplied by an I hat, that's equal to minus 1. Now, that probably looks familiar from imaginary numbers, right? So I squared is equal to minus 1, so that should look familiar. Now, let's look at I hat multiplied by J hat. Well, I times J is actually K hat, so a vector, and that's kind of similar to a cross product, right? If you have a component in the I direction crossed with J, then you get something out in the K direction. And so following the right-handed rule, I times K equals minus J. So I'll just complete these here. So we have J crossed with I, or multiplied by I, is equal to the minus K hat direction. A J multiplied by a J is again equal to minus 1. A J multiplied by K is equal to I. K times I is equal to J. K times J is equal to minus I. And K multiplied by K is again equal to minus 1. Okay, so you can see I times I is minus 1, J times J is minus 1, and a K times K is minus 1. Okay, so those are kind of similar to imaginary numbers. And then everything on the off diagonals here are follow the right-hand rule. So an IJ gives us a K, a J crossed with I is a minus K. Okay, so we could go through that and work all of this out. And I'm just gonna drop the solution on here. So so this is the solution for the multiplication of two quaternions. And so we have A multiplied by B, and this is it written out in longhand there. And then once we work through all of this stuff and replace all the I times I is going to be a negative 1, for example. So that's going to now make this term a scalar, right? So we're going to have an AX times a BX that's a scalar multiplied by negative 1. And so that shows up here, right here. So we've got this first line is the scalar that comes out of this. We've got the A naught B naught that we had talked about before. That's the first scalar. The second scalar is AX BY. And then we've got AYBY and AZBZ because this was a J hat times a J hat and a K hat times a K hat. So those all return negative 1 multiplied by those values here. So this first line is the scalar that comes out for this quaternion product. And then we get components in the I direction, J direction, and K direction. Now I'm using slightly different notation here in this write-up. So this is the I direction, IX. The IY is the J hat direction, and then this is the K hat direction. Okay, so we could work through, and I won't go through it, but see, we've got an I times a J, for example, and that's going to give us a K hat. So we should end up with an AX times a BY in the K hat direction, and that term is right there. Okay, so this resembles, you know, this is kind of a mix. It feels like a mix of imaginary numbers, a mix of vector algebra. And so let's actually look at the special case where, a couple different things. First of all, let's look at just a scalar. So if we have two quaternions where all of the components in I, J, and K are zero, and so we just have real numbers from the scalars, the only thing that's going to come out of that is a scalar, okay? So two quaternions multiplied together where the vector components are all zero, just gives us a scalar, A0 times B0. Okay, but now what if we take a quaternion where the scalar component is 0, but the vector components are non-zero for both of these? Okay, so that means A0 and B0 would both be 0, but then we have non-zero values for these other components. So I'm just gonna put a line through these components here in this derivation that would be 0. So A0, B0, A0, so all of these go to 0. Then we've got B0 here, B0, and B0, okay? So what we're left with is this stuff right here. We're left with this stuff right here, this right there, and these terms right here. So I'm just going to drop that as another example here. And actually, let's move this on to the next page here. Okay, so this is the example of a vector of two quaternions multiplied together that are actually just vectors, okay? So this is vector multiplication using the quaternion product. Okay, so this is what we get here. So we've got A multiplied by B. Now notice these don't have squigglies around them because these are just vectors, but we're using the quaternion product. So the scalar component of these quaternions is zero. So we end up with this term right up here. So this is where that term, we still have this scalar component that comes out of it when we do this multiplication, this quaternion multiplication. And so even though we started with two vectors where the scalar, two quaternions where the scalar components were zero, we're still going to get out a quaternion where the scalar component is non-zero. The scalar component that comes out of this is actually equal to the negative of the dot product of the two vectors. And then the vector component that comes out of this is equal to the cross product of the two vectors. So when we do quaternion product on two vectors, it's a combination of the dot product and the cross product. Okay, so these are just some interesting things with quaternion multiplication. And now we're going to talk about some other properties that you should be aware of in quaternion algebra. Before we do, I just want to point out one thing that hopefully has become clear to you. So these are some of the rules, you know, that go along with this quaternion algebra and are kind of fundamental to this idea of a quaternion product. And this is exactly what Hamilton was actually expressing or writing down on that bridge. He carved this into the side of the bridge, that I squared equals J squared equals K squared equals minus 1. And also I times J times K is also equal to minus 1. So anyway, hopefully that equation now makes more sense to you, and that has to do with this quaternion product.